I guess you're watching this video because your computer is running with an issue here as you're trying to open up a recently installed this server alert. The problem can start because xdaudio1_4.dll is missing from my computer. It's a somewhat critical error, and all you need to do is watch this video patiently and follow that method on your computer. Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Evolution. In this very short video, I'll be fixing this error within 3 minutes. So let's get started. The first thing you need to do is open your favorite browser and search for xdaudio1_4.dll and choose any result you want. In this case, I'll be choosing the first one. This is not sponsored, but I'll put the link in the description. You can see few download options based on the architecture and version. To know your architecture and version, click on start and search for system information. Here you can see mine is 64-bit as I'm updated to the recent Windows update. So in this case, I'll be downloading the first one. I strongly recommend you to read this page. It has other fixing method also. As the download complete, hit open. Here is the DLL file. To move the DLL, first open this PC, then local disk C, Windows, and find a folder named system32. This is the home of 32-bit DLL files. Then click on the downloaded zip, drag the DLL, and drop. I have already done this, so it is asking me to replace and click on continue to give administrator access. Before we go ahead, let's check. By typing the entire file name, you can see the file is placed in 32-bit folder. So job is done for 32-bit users. You can go and restart your computer. Only if you are a 64-bit users. Open this PC one more time, then new volume C, Windows, and this time find a folder named syswall64. This is the home of 64-bit DLL files, and similarly drag and drop. In short, 64-bit users need to place the file in both 32-bit folder and 64-bit folder. Check this one more time. By typing the file, you can see the file is perfectly placed in 32-bit folder and 64-bit folder. And finally, restart your computer. Next, in rare cases, if there are OT lockers, you need to download and install latest Microsoft DirectX and install your program again, and that will surely fix it.
And that's all. If you follow me step by steps, you'll no longer have that problem left. Please let me know how you feel about this video. And do not forget to like and subscribe.